Tengo una gran oportunidad para ti. That's Spanish for I got a big opportunity for you.
Ignoring your terrible Spanish for a second, what's the opportunity?
WWE was contacted to send a PC student to El Mago's retirement show in Mexico. They actually requested Hector, but for some reason he doesn't want to do it. So if you're interested, we'll have a triple threat between you, Paragon, and Chase to decide who will go to face El Mago's son, El Mago Jr., at the event.
Reservar mi vuelo, which means book my flight.
I only looked up that one sentence, so I'll take your word for it.
Oh. I was in a bit of a philosophical mood last night, and I started to wonder. If you never have a chance to use your finishing move, is it still a finisher? Or is it just a regular old move?
What are you getting at?
I guess I was thinking about how dominating my finisher is going to be in the WWE, but you guys are probably never even going to get to use yours, which is kind of sad. Total waste of some perfectly good finishing moves.
I don't think you have to worry about that, since I guarantee I could hit my finisher on you today.
Really? Okay, well, how about we have a little fatal four-way finisher match? First one to hit theirs wins.
Deal. I look forward to showing you that my finishing move is not gonna go to waste.
I haven't checked in with you for a bit. Are you holding up?
Don't act like you care about me. It's every man for himself here, and you know it.
Maybe. But that doesn't mean we have to be enemies. But maybe my old man was right. He always said, never trust a man who doesn't trust a man.
Wow. That's deep. He's still giving you gems like that these days?
No. We're not really on speaking terms.
I kind of wish we weren't either.
If you don't want to talk, then let's continue this in the ring. Lucha libre style. Best 2 out of 3 falls.
So you're saying I get to beat you twice? Deal.
One! Ha!
I was watching some older stuff on the network the other day, and it got me thinking how cool it would be to have a hardcore match. But it's pointless since the coaches would never let us do it.
Well, what if, and hear me out on this, we did it super early in the morning before anyone got here.
How would we even get in the building?
I'm boys with Todd, the security guard. He gave me my own key.
That guy really is bad at his job.
We'd come in here bright and early, have our hardcore match, clean up all the plunder, and no one finds out. Trust me, it'll be fine.
My gut's telling me this could be a disaster, but for some reason, I still want to do it. You got yourself a hardcore match.
Oh!
Guys, what the heck?
It was like this when we came in?
Clean it up now, and then come find me. We're gonna have a little talk. So, give it to me straight. Who do I blame for what went down out there?
It was all my idea. So whatever punishment you want to hand out should fall on me.
That's not true. It was my idea. It was actually a tribute to your reign as hardcore champion in 1998.
Don't be a suck up. All right, here's the deal. Since you're both taking the blame, you both get the punishment. A WWE tag team just happens to be stopping by later today, and they like to get hardcore too.
Didn't you vacate the hardcore title? So technically, you're still champ in my book.
That's a good point. You know what? That's not important right now. Later today, you two are gonna face the Usos in a hardcore match. Have fun.
Yeah! The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from the United States of America. Weighing in at 225 pounds, Squire. His opponent from East London, weighing in at 190 pounds, Danny Burch.
Thank you.